of Java. So I installed already. I will show you how to set a path by two ways. The JDK will install on C drive, that is program files here we can see the Java folder, and in that the JDK 1.7.0 version will be there, and the path will be set by two ways. Here we copy that path, and then it will set in my computer property or this PC property. Here the control panel system security, you can directly go this PC by properties, or you can go directly control panel system security and system. Here the one tab is there, advanced system setting, and that time the window will pop up on in front of you, the system property, and here is the button environment variable. Here already path will be set, but we can use JDK 1.7 version. So I will delete that path, or I will set that path. New, here we paste that path, semicolon, and after that OK will be there, and then the temp or path, or directly you can check, or you can set a new user variables. Java home, in capital Java underscore home, and then variable value will be your path. You can paste it here and then OK. Click on OK and then again click OK. Then close your window. This will be one step for you can set your path. You can set your path by this way. This is the first way, and after that you can set it by a command prompt. You can set here is path. It will be set here. You can type here set class path equal to sign percentage, and then double quote here, and after that again percent sign. Okay, if here not shown any error, if it is shown any error, it will show any error or any message to you that it is not sufficient, or it is not syntax error, or it will be missed, you have semicolon or anything else, then it will not set a path by temporary. But here we can set a class path for temporary on command prompt for C user BCA. You can use everywhere by any drive, by D drive, E drive, or anything else. You can set it here, and you can use by using. Firstly, when you use any command for that, so Java C is not showing because we are installed JDK, but we are not restart the PC from here, and we can restart it here. Now we are connecting to database, that is the Java
application will be connected to database. Previously we are seeing that we are connecting to database. So in this PPT, conceptual components, that is what are the steps we are going to connecting to database. These are steps for Java application to connecting to database. First, import the necessary classes. Import the necessary classes means what? Firstly, you must import java.sql or import javax.sql. That is, the SQL means structure query language, and here we are importing that API for that SQL. After that, second number, the load the JDBC driver, that is the class for dot name. Class dot for name means class, this class is by default coming from import java.lang package, and after that we are importing the class dot for name. Class dot for name, this method will show the instance, returning the instance of that class. Means when we are using class dot for name method to JDBC driver, in bracket we are importing, that is here you can see here class dot for name, this is the first line, load the driver, and here we are using com.cloudspace.core JDBC driver. And after that, if we are not using this type of driver, then we can use the first type of driver, means sun.jdbc.odbc JDBC ODBC driver. Okay, here you can see, here you can see that this is the first line, class dot for name sun dot jdbc dot odbc JDBC ODBC driver. This is the first line, the load the JDBC driver, and here after that the identify the data source. Identify the data source means when we create a database, when we create a database means if we are using MS Access, then we can firstly create, right click on any drive, after that create one Microsoft Access database, and give that name. I give the name, company name. Okay, this line means we are creating database in MS Access, Oracle or MySQL. Okay, or directly we can use, if we are using Postgre Sybase database, then we can physically create means that I will show you how we creating a database. Here this PC, and this is the advanced Java, and here the company database. I am delete this database. Okay, now you can see how I create a database. Firstly, right click on any space, then click on Microsoft Access database. Okay, and here give a name, company. Okay, then enter it or select it. This is the database we are not creating here. See, we are not creating here any type of table or any type of relationships in that, or query or any type procedure. Okay, so firstly I close it. Okay, Then this is the third, fourth line. Establish the connection. Establish connection means what? The connection, I want to connect with database. I want to connect with database. How I connect with database? Here the start button is there. Physically, firstly create on select button, select or start button, then select on settings, after that select on system, and here you type here administrative tools. Here is the administrative tools. You can see here administrative tools. Okay, this is administrative tools, and by default Windows will provide a services for this to use Windows. Okay, here I firstly open ODBC, that I already told you ODBC is defined or ODBC is already developed in C language, and in ODBC the first type of driver we are using, that n-type ODBC data source administrator. Here three tabs is there: user DSN, system DSN, and file DSN. System DSN, here first click company that I already remove. Okay, that already I remove. The system DSN means firstly add the data source. Which type of data source you want? I am using MS Access. If you are using Oracle, then you can select here Oracle. Okay, you can select it Oracle. Okay, Microsoft ODBC for Oracle. Okay, and if you are using MySQL, then you can select it SQL Server. But I already in front of you created Microsoft Access driver, so here I select Microsoft Access driver .mdb.accdb. MDB means we are using, if we are using Microsoft Office 2003 or before that version, Office version, and that extension will be, the extension will be .mdb. And if we are using Microsoft Office 2007, then we are the extension will be .accdb. And here Microsoft Access driver select, then finish it here. Here you can see the empty database, the connection will be empty above this button. Okay, and data source name is empty. Then what I have given the name to that database, company. Okay, after that I will select where is it from E drive and advanced Java. Here the company.accdb is database name, is a database name in which drive, E drive, and advanced Java, in that folder the company.accdb that I already created. Okay, so I select it, then you can see here the E drive, advanced Java folder, and company.accdb. Here is the path of that database. Okay, then click on OK. After that, company is already exist, replace it with this definition that I firstly created for you, and after that I delete in front of you. So here I again created company database and click on OK. Okay, so close it control panel, and here the established connection. Established connection means what? Established connection. But I firstly load the JDBC driver. The first type of driver we are using here, sun.jdbc.jdbc.odbc driver. And after that connection, in this connection, connection con is equal to driver manager dot get connection. The second line of that in that program, second line, okay, sorry, okay, here is the next. And here the connection is there. Connection means what? Connection is an interface we are importing from import java.sql. Connection is an interface. We are created here a variable connection. After that is equal to driver manager is a class, right? And dot get connection, this is an method. Class dot get connection means directly class call a method, means it is a static method. In that source URL, in that you can see the string will be pasted here. The source, what is the source? JDBC:ODBC:music. This is a source. Source means JDBC, the first protocol, :ODBC sub protocol, and the third part is DSN. DSN means what we already created, a company database. Okay, that is a DSN. Here there are three methods. Right here you can see JDBC URL provides a way to identify database protocol that I show you. JDBC:ODBC, that is sub protocol ODBC, after that colon protocol means DSN name. In that JDBC:ODBC movies, this is the example that I give a company name. Okay, JDBC:ODBC:movies. Okay, here okay, after establish a connection con is equal to driver manager dot get connection, means I establish a connection with a database. And next I want to select a statement, that is a platform. I want to send a request to that database, and then I want to get result from that database, right? Create a statement object. Here a statement object that are created, a statement, it is an interface. Statement stmt is equal to con dot create statement. The line will create a statement object. The line will create a statement object. In that, the query will be fired by using a statement object. The query will be fired or execute with using a statement object. That I will show you in that first. This is a program, and here class dot for name, that is load a JDBC driver, that is load JDBC driver, sun.jdbc.odbc.jdbc.odbc driver. This is the instance creating and returning to that instance, to that class. Okay, and after that connection is an interface. Connection con is equal to driver manager is a class. Connection is an interface. Okay, connection con is equal to driver manager dot get connection. Get connection is a static method which will acquire the protocol, sub protocol and DSN name. Okay, JDBC colon ODBC protocol, sub protocol and DSN name. Then we are using a statement object. Statement STMT is equal to con dot create statement. Con dot create statement means what? Con means connection object dot create statement. Connection object using a create statement, and then assign to STMT means statement object. And after that the query will, we are write up here, the query will write here select star from employee. We know that company database we created, but employee table is not created. Understand, company database we already created, but in that employee table is not created. Then result set means what? Result set, what we are given from a database, we are holding a RS object. The RS object will hold all the database data that fetch from database. Then is equal to STMT. STMT means what? Statement object dot execute query SQL first. Execute query means what? Execute query means that is the method what the STMT object using a execute query means. It compile first and then execute it next, the SQL first. That is the query will write here assigned to one string object. Okay, string object, and this object will paste it here assigned to execute query. Statement dot execute query SQL first, then while RS dot next. Then while RS dot next means what? RS dot next. Next method will move that cursor from one row to another row. In table, if I created, this is a database, and we create one table design view. I will give that table employee, right? Okay, if you are not sure, then you can firstly copy this and then paste it here. I think I am sure employee. Okay, and you can write here directly. Okay, and okay it. Then auto number then primary key use name text name text, then address. Okay, address, then pin code, it is a number there, number is there. Okay, that I will save that employee table. Okay, I will save that employee table. after that a company that in company database employee table will be created, then I will give the name, my name, then this is the location, that is address, pin code number, after that okay, okay, then okay, then save it here, okay, close it. Here we are executing a SQL query, that is select star from employee, okay. The result set object RS, result set object RS is holding all fetch data from table, employee table, and the next method will move the cursor, cursor point means from here, from ID, when firstly the row will fetch, the data will be fetched, that is ID, name, address and pin code, the first row data will fetch, but next method what will it will do, then it will move the cursor to next row, it will move the cursor point next row, again third row, and again next row. When it will false the condition, that is while loop, it will false the condition rs.next, next, the next means third, after third row the next move will be empty, the next row will be empty, so that it will false and coming to directly goes from that loop, okay. But when rs.next method, the system.out.println id is equal to rs.getInt first, rs.getInt first means first column, that is first id number, that is this is first column, this is second column, this is third column, this is fourth column, okay, understand, first, second, third and fourth, these are fourth columns in that table, and here we are using third, okay, third, the rs.getInt, getInt means what, the integer number or any number we are getting from that table, which table, employee table, rs.getInt first column, name rs.getInt to second column, that is, and after that the rs.getString third column, okay, understand. If we use the fourth column, I will use the fourth column, okay. Here I will use a fourth column, that is here I will pin code, okay, pin code means pin code, and the number will be here fourth column, okay, here fourth column, okay, right, understand. Save it, this program, and here you can see first column, second column, third column and fourth column, okay, first, second, third and fourth, Okay, I will close it. The RS object will hold all the data in that. Here we are partitioning, we are breaking that data into that column wise statement. ID means we are getting only ID, okay, name, then address, and then pin code number. That is, we are using println. Println means next line. So firstly, ID rs.getInt. What we are getting, we know that we must know that we are getting integer type of number. We are getting integer type of number. This is a string. We are getting string text type of data. Here we are using get string means we are getting means we are fetching data from database or table, text type or string type. Pin code we are getting here int type, means we are using here int type, and here I will save it. Okay, then after third row that I will show that table to you. Employee table, I will insert a three names in that. After that, if there is no any data, then it will directly come out from that loop. And here we are using a close statement, close method here. Object will be close here means by the steps of JDBC connection. Here I will show you retrieving data from return the result object. Okay, I will explain that. Close result set and statement and connection object in order. When we are opening in what order, ascending order. Okay, ascending order, we are opening a object con, after that statement object, after that result set object. Okay, so by reverse order we can close all the object. Result set, the last object will open, and after that firstly close that object rs.close. Second stmt statement object will open for that. So after that, in opposite order, the statement object will be closed, and firstly the con object will, connection, the object will be open, then close con.close. okay, understand? Okay, after that the try and catch statement we are using here. The try and catch statement, why we use here? Class not found exception. So class dot for name, for this statement we are using class not found exception. If we are not using this type of exception, then we are caught exception in this program. Okay, so we firstly used try and catch statement. In catch statement, class not found exception means if the instance will create of that class, if not using a driver manager, then we have to handle that exception, class not found exception. Okay, so here I am writing a class not found exception catch block, and after that SQL exception for what? The query will fire to database. And which table? Employee table. So physically we are connecting to that employee table, what are the steps to connecting the table? Firstly, go to start button. After that, setting control panel, open control panel window, and then go to system. After that, go to administrative tools. After that, open ODBC source administrator, then select tab system DSM, and after that add data source. Okay, data source, which type of MDB and .sccdb. After that, click on OK and then select the path. We are already selecting that E drive, then advanced Java, and then company database. Okay, then click on OK. After that, the query will fire. Okay, the query will fire on database. The database will fetch that table data which is holding the RS object, but the SQL exception when we are using query, SQL query, structure query, for this we are using SQL exception, will not any show runtime error or any compile time exception. Okay, compile time error or runtime error. So that we are using here catch statement in that SQL exception CE and system out.println CE. Okay, this program I will save it. Okay, then open command prompt here, go to E drive, then advanced Java, okay, and then Java C, JDBC 1, save this program JDBC 1.java, okay, 1.java. I will compile it. Okay, it will make class file, and then I will execute it, run command Java JDBC 1. Okay, and the data will fetch and show you this type of result. Okay, ID first, name Pushkar, add Shrirampur, pin code number, and this what we are creating in employee table, what we are inserting a data into that. So it will show to you. Okay, it will show to you that is already we are inserted into database. Okay, then by using close the result statement and connection object in order, reverse order. After that, driver manager. Okay, so firstly you can write here the basic steps connecting to database. Okay, write down